Championship Wrestling, the most exciting hour in television. And during this hour, you're going to see plenty of champions in action. Speaking of champions, here are two right now, the World Tag Team Champions, Ricky Morton, Robert Gibson, Rock and Roll Express. Robert?
How you doing, Bob? It's a pleasure to be here. You know, all the fans are here. We're getting a lot of mail, a lot of letters. Right? Let me tell you something, fans. We read all the letters and all the mail. We don't get a chance to answer all of them. We sure do appreciate all the fan mail we're getting.
All right, and Rick, I know that you're still thinking about the Koloffs and the Russians, but there's another team that you got to be on the lookout for, and that's this Midnight Express.
That's right, Bob. You know, the Russians are still hot on our trail, brother, wanting these belts back. But Jimmy Cornette's been making a lot of accusations, saying things about the Rock and Roll Express. But Jimmy Cornette, now it's time to put up or shut up, boy. Because I know your Midnight Express is a tough team, but look at us. We are the NWA World Tag Team Champions. You know, it's like that solid gold rock and roll. You can't beat it. Jimmy Cornette, it's like the Rock and Roll Express. Your Midnight Express can't beat us, brother. So get ready. We're going to meet you sooner or later. And then we're going to see if you can back up all the things you said about the Rock and Roll Express. Woo!
All right, fans, the World Tag Team Champions, Rock and Roll Express, and we're going to be seeing them in action a little bit later on. Talking about champions, we've got one in the ring right now, so let's go to the ring, and he's there ready to go. Magnum T.A., the U.S. champ. Here he is. Johnny Weaver, this should be an exciting match. Magnum T.A. and Vernon Deaton.
The Mac over here, Bob, because, you know, Magnum's had a lot of quick victories to his credit.
Started out, you can tell that the U.S. champ really means business because he came out in a hurry, went right to work on Deaton.
With that belt back in his possession, a lot of top talent lined up to get a shot at that. Arn Anderson, Abdul the Butcher, the Barbarian, and of course Tully Blanchard still in that match. Wrestling maneuver, Fireman Scary takedown. A lot of points will be scored by Magnum. He's going for that victory, Bob.
Well, he can really put the pressure in an arm, too, when he gets that arm bar on like he's got it now.
Go through a lot of tough battles that Tully Blanchard before he's able to get that U.S. belt back. I quit match with the Starrcade with a big victory for Magnum. There's a lot of people going to line up for that belt right now.
Dusty Rhodes. Dusty, I know the World TV title tournament has got to mean a lot to you, but I also know this thing with Ric Flair, it can't just end like this. It can't go away, Dusty.
No, Bobby, it cannot go away. It never will. You know, the World's TV title belongs to Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, because there was no man put Dusty Rhodes' shoulder to the ground to defeat me for the World's television title. Now with the big tournament coming up, January the 4th, Dusty Rhodes is gearing for that thing. Secondly, just returned from Kansas City, Missouri, talking to Bob Gagel extensively. Actually sat across the table from the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Actually seen him eyeball to eyeball, wondering about what his next move going to be. He is the World's Heavyweight Champion, they say. They say nothing about Dusty Rhodes defeating Ric Flair at Starrcade 85, which I did. So Ric Flair, the Nature Boy, the Slick Rick, if you will, down the road, That is what we're going to have to deal with now, is because I want that more than anything. Well, I came back from a serious injury to be what I am right here. Defeated you, 1, 2, 3. Iron Ole Anderson, somewhere down the road, I'm going to start hurting somebody now. I'm going to start taking care of business and hurting somebody. You know, when I was really bad off and I had that leg laid up, I got a little place out in Colorado that I go to. And Dusty Rhodes, I went up to Colorado and I called a few of my ex, if you will, fiancés. There was 10 of them. They came out there and I was there in a little room and they say, they all talk, I can hear them talking outside. And they say, I don't know what to do to the Dream. And Betty Lou is my favorite squeeze, you know. She said, well, let me go in and talk to him. 4 hours later, she came back out with a big smile on her face. And Ric Flair, this is what she says. You can't keep a good man down, baby.
The American Dream, Dusty Rhodes fans. We'll be right back. We'll have more after we take your free time out. Siding at the bell. Right now we're looking at a team that's certainly a threat for the World Tag Team Championship. Dula the Butcher and his partner the Barbarian. Johnny Weaver, they're two awesome individuals in any ring.
Just unbelievable team put together by, at least we forget, number one Paul Jones.
Jim Jeffers went right through the ropes and he's down on the floor as Abdullah is such a big, strong, rough, tough individual. Johnny, you just can't handle a man that size.
And the tactics he uses makes it extremely difficult to try to wrestle with a man like this. And that was an unbelievable team, the Barbarians. Oh, but what about them in that bunkhouse? Bob, that's right. Here you have some information on the bunkhouse.
That's right, Johnny. The first bunkhouse stampede won by Magnum TA in Cleveland, Ohio. And fans, there are several more bunkhouse matches scheduled around the country. And if one is near you, be sure you see it. Don't miss that. What an event it is. It's an exciting event. One you'll always dread it if you miss it, Johnny. It's just that exciting.
These two individuals that Paul Jones has in there, Bob, would certainly have to be the top contenders in a match like that.
When you talk about the disdain for the rules when he just had Jeffers in the air, holding him up by the hand, just hanging him in the air.
Doesn't get any easier for the opponents once they tag. Neither the strength of the Barbarian is out. Now you have the size and the rugged tactics of them.
To
the delight of no one except number one Paul Jones, as the Barbarian and Abdullah have just been destructive against the Jeffers. Have the battle, the tide of battle changed against him.
Well, that was a beautiful suplex. He really got a lot of height on that move, Johnny, and a lot of power down to the mat with it.
Warrior Strength and Barbarian. Either one of those men, Abdullah or the Barbarian, can carry over the top rope. Paul Jones and his two, Abdullah the Butcher, down there with the bell, and right back here, the Barbarian. Paul, after just watching them in the ring, you got to have title aspirations for these two. They got to be right at the top of the list.
Bob, I always say, if you got a bell, ring it. You people seen Abdullah the Butcher and the Barbarian in action. And you're probably asking yourself, why? Why aren't these two men the world champions? Why do you see Rock and Roll Express running with the belts on around their waist and the girls screaming? The girls could be screaming for Abdullah the Butcher and the Barbarian because they are two men. They should have those belts in the ring. And I'll tell you something right now, you people. We are so frustrated, so tired, aggravated, that the minute that we get a title match with them in the ring, these men are biting at their bits. It ain't gonna last 30 seconds because they're not geared to go any longer than 30 seconds when they get in the ring for a title. It seems like everybody's a champion of this, a champion of that. All I'm asking is the opportunity. Put the belts up. Bob, you know why I don't get the opportunity. I'll tell you why, because the champions, nobody wants to lose. Well, Rock and Roll Express, if you want to be true champions, if you want to be able to look yourself in the mirror and say, I am a champion, then you have to get in the ring and face Abdullah the Butcher and the Barbarian. You name the place, and we'll be there to collect their belts.
All right, fans. Champions in the ring, the Rock and Roll Express. What an exciting combination these two young men are, Johnny.
And they have this place jumping already. By the time they walked out of the dressing room, electrified the crowd. Let's see them go to work against the Golden Terror and Ron Russell.
Yeah!
of the Rock and Roll Express right there. Now they got their belts back. A lot of teams are in line for it.
You know, Johnny, a lot of people thought that, well, it just was luck that the Rock and Roll Express defeated the Russians, as rough and tough as they are, for the World Tag Team Championship. But when they did it twice, boy, they made believers out of everybody in the wrestling world.
Especially when they hit under the belts around the first time.
Just great athletes, fans, and when you watch them around the ring, you can tell what tremendous athletes they are just by the way they move. And their timing is just a thing of beauty to behold. As a tag team, they have their timing right down to perfection.
Usually set them up, Bob, for that double drop kick, and that takes tremendous coordination.
The Taro would like to get across the ring and make a tag.
I know when they look over their shoulder and see that list of teams behind them, the Andersons, the Barbarian, Abdullah with Paul Jones, the Russians, and the Midnight Express. They got to stay with that timing. They got to keep that ability in that.
Well, that's where quickness really pays off for you. It did right there for Robert Gibson.
Quickness, a great gifted asset, Bob.
Now we'll get a look at Ron Rossi. Right now at ringside, the U.S. champ, Magnum T.A. Magnum, you had to get into trenches for that. What a battle. I don't think anybody has ever had to fight a tougher fight than the I Quit match to win a championship, Magnum.
Well, thank you very much. I honestly have to agree with you. You know, the quest for a championship, such as United States Heavyweight Championship, is something that all of us as professional athletes thrive on. It's that thing that keeps us going. It's that thing that makes us go through all the pain barriers, keep on when most ordinary people would quit, and go on to attain the goals that you've sought. United States Heavyweight Championship was that goal that I was after. I have achieved it. But now the true challenge presents itself to me, because as a champion, I have to face all the top competition in the world. Anybody that thinks they can knock me off the top, the United States Heavyweight Championships, take this away from me, then I have to meet all those challenges right there in the square circle, right there in the ring. Now, when you talk about the top competitors, speaking of men such as Ole and Arn Anderson, like them or not, they are very tough, rugged individuals. They have proven themselves on more than one occasion to be championship caliber men. And then you also have the Russians. You have Ivan Koloff, the senior member. You have Nikita Koloff, the strong man. You've got Crusher Khrushchev, maybe the biggest of them all. Any of those men at any time could present a probable cause, something to back me into a corner and having to defend the United States Heavyweight Championship. But one man that certainly has to be recognized is the national heavyweight champion, Buddy Landell. Buddy, under the tutelage of James J. Dillon, has made quite a name for himself in professional wrestling. When he first came to the NWA, I kind of felt like he was a little too cocky for his own good. cocky he still is, but now he has to be recognized as the national heavyweight champion, recognized as possibly the number one contender for the United States Heavyweight Championship. So, Buddy Landell, wherever you may be out there, if you feel like you're ready, if you want to take a bite out of me, if you want to take a shot at the United States Heavyweight title, then you don't have to look very far, because there's always an open contract out there for you. If you think you can be a better man, go for it, because I'm not backing down from anybody. And when you fill out this list, there's one man that certainly can't be overlooked. That is the man, Tully Blanchard, the man that I did go the distance with. I went through the most brutal match of my entire life, went inside a steel cage, locked in, and came out the victor. Tully Blanchard, I am the United States Heavyweight Champion. And if you think you can take this away from me, I'm here waiting for you, big boy.
All right, fans, right now, back at ringside, we want to get the National Tag Team Champions in and have a word with them, Ole, of course, and Arn Anderson. Arn, we're talking about those belts, but I know you got another belt on your mind also.
Well, I'm going to tell you real precisely and concisely what it's all about. You've thrown the best that you can put together to come get these national tag team titles. You've come up short every time. America's team, right on down. You've come up short. But Bob Caudle, the thing that's pressing on my mind, we are the national tag team champions. There's nothing you can do about that. But the mark of a good athlete is to be able to overcome adversity. So Dusty Rhodes, you came out here and hit me in the back of the head with a chair and took my world television title, but I'm just going to win that tournament and show the whole world I am truly the world television champion.
Ole?
You got that smile on your face. We come out here and we've got all these people talking about the Rock and Roll Express, talking about Magnum TA, Dusty Rhodes, wait till I get a hold of you, Wahoo McDaniel's looking for us. Well, everybody's looking. Now, why is it that we're so hard to find? Here we are on national television all over the world. This TV goes to Europe. It goes to Japan. It goes all over the United States. It goes to Hawaii. It goes to Guam. It goes to every country that's got a TV set and a reception. So who in the world is having a hard time finding us? Rock and roll, it's a disgrace to have somebody like the Rock and Roll Express, even in wrestling. They got all those little armbands around them. They got all the little trinkets around their head. Does that make them a good wrestler? You better look at this face and look at that one. You're going to see some knots. You're going to see a bunch of scars. We didn't get it from playing rock and roll. We didn't get it from walking around with little handkerchiefs around our leg. We got it because we stuck our nose in there and we wrestled. We do that better than anybody in the world today, and that's why we're the champions. If you have any accept of that, you have any doubt about it, try us out, because we're always ready for anybody.
The National Tag Team Champions, the Raging Bull in the Ring, fans. Manny Fernandez, the Raging Bull, and Mark Fleming, his opponent across the way.
No matter how big a name you mention in the wrestling profession, this man's name, the Raging Bull, has got to be right along to the side of him. The fans love to see the Bull in action. He gives them so much action. Oh, what a surprise for Mark Fleming. Of course, Mexican heritage, and that he has a great big sombrero, Bob, as his prized possession. When he puts that up in a Mexican death match on that pole, the opponent better watch out.
Well, he's showing you, too, that he's ready, Johnny, how quick he's moving around the ring. Twice he came into a headlock. He got a head scissors on Mark Fleming. Fleming tried to reverse it on him there, but the Bull is really getting around the ring very well.
Tremendous ability and the Raging Bull, and he's displayed it in big arenas all over the world.
Fans, when you talk about ability and being on display, let's remind all of you fans again about the World Television Title Tournament, which is coming up on January 4th. Johnny, listen to this. Already we've had a couple of entries that we know about. Harley Race, 7 times World Heavyweight Champion, has got to be an entry. And Wahoo McDaniel also has entered. That's got to be some of them. Hey.
Well, it sure is a prestigious title, the World TV belt, and of course, it'll attract the biggest name in the NWA. The competition will be fierce and at its best, and at its will peak out the night of the tournament. Fleming, he's turned it all loose, pulled out all the stops. An intense competitor in there.
How about it, Fleming?
Really got that head scissors on Mark Fleming. He's wearing them down, Bob, but look for that flying burrito.
Shit. Okay.
Johnny, with that knee to the back and that chin like he's got it, Nabul can really get the pressure on that neck and also on that head, can he, with that position?
And he can take a lot out of his opponent, right? Happens to be Mark Fleming over here. Nabul seems like he's opening up the attack, Bob.
Fans, right now, here's the former United States champion, Tully Blanchard, his perfect 10 baby doll. Tully, you keep saying that in the I Quit match with Magnum TA that you didn't quit.
Well, Bob Cottle, you know, you can listen to the people out here. Every arena all over the country, they like to say, I quit, I quit, I quit. Tully Blanchard, quitter, quitter, quitter. Well, I got news for you people out there. The words, I quit, which the match was, and I didn't want it in the first place, never came across these lips.
Tully, I was there. I heard you
Bob
say
Tyler,
I quit.
You were in the Omni in Atlanta watching on satellite with the rest of the people in the world. You never, ever heard the words come out of my mouth. I guarantee you, and I don't want to call you right here in front of God and everybody a liar, so don't be making statements like that. Magnum TA, you can walk around and carry the United States Heavyweight Championship belt because the referee gave it to you. But you know, and I know, and you and I may be the only two people in the entire world that know the words I quit never, ever came from Tully Blanchard's mouth. Now, Magnum TA, you want to talk and spend all your time talking about everybody else. And that's fine, because you talk about them. Because I tell you what, you talk about them and ignore me is not going to erase the fact that I'm there. And you can talk about the 34 successful defenses I had against you alone. Excuse me. Against you alone. Every type of match you wanted. And Excuse me.
Well, Tully, I tell you, yeah, that's just how excited and emotional you are. You get really choked up when you get to talking about Magnum TA. You know.
That is Bob Cottle. I never said the words. Right here, Magnum TA, you get back in the ring, wrestling match, I will walk out the U.S. Heavyweight Champion.
Fans, you're looking right there at the NWA, the National Tag Team Championship belt right around the waist of Arn Anderson, as we're going to watch Arn, even though he's a tag team champion, in a single match here against Ricky Reeve. And Johnny, this should be some exciting match. Two pretty evenly matched individuals with size and muscle composure, but I don't know, Arn Anderson up there in the ring, Ole Anderson right here at ringside. Ole, you look very intense as you're watching the beginning of the match.
Well, you made a comment about being equal in size. That may be true, but there's certainly other things to be considered, like skill and experience. When you talk about skill and experience, then you've got to definitely be in favor of Arn Anderson.
Those two things are really hard to overcome, Ole.
There's no way that you're going to get it in a couple of days or a year or 15 years of amateur wrestling. The only way you're going to get it is by going out there and wrestling. Professional wrestling is a ball game unto itself. Nothing like it in the world.
I heard you say earlier that you and Arn have paid your dues, that you came the hard way, that you took the knocks and the things that it took to do it, Ole, and that's the reason that you're two at the top.
Is there any question? You interview a lot of people. You see them out here. There's some guys that get by because they're good looking and they know some wrestling, but it comes right down to getting in there and having the fight. If you put them into a snake pit, maybe they'd back out. They want to make sure everything is just so. Everybody follows the rules. They want to make sure that the referee is always there to help them if they're in trouble. The Andersons don't worry about referees. We don't worry about rules. We don't worry if you want to bring in anything at all. That's why this bunkhouse stampede match is right down our alley. $20,000, everybody wants the money. But who wants to get in there and grub like you've got to in order to win that money? The Andersons is the only team I know that are capable of winning.
No!
Well, Arn caught a couple of blows, but he came back with that return punch, Ole. So he's going to dish it out as well as take it then. If anybody lands a blow, they're going to have to take him back from Arn.
I'll tell you what, we know we're going to get hurt. We know we're going to have to expect to get a couple of punches. In fact, we'll many times go out there and willingly take a couple of punches from somebody, because when we take them and our opponent sees that it doesn't faze us, then all of a sudden he starts to wonder, what in the world have I got here? Who am I talking to? What kind of a man am I wrestling? And of course, now our reputation precedes us everywhere we go. People know. There's still a few diehards around. Still a Dusty Rhodes that hasn't learned. There's still a Magnum TA that's being tutored by Dusty Rhodes. So the same sort of thinking goes through his head. That's almost non-thinking. And you've got people like the Rock and Roll Express who are riding so high on emotion. Somebody needs to bring him back down.
Let me tell you something now. They made believers of me when not once, but twice they defeated the Russians. Not many teams can say that.
No, but let me ask you this. Because the New York Yankees lose a game, does that mean they're not any good? You're going to tell me because the Chicago Bears lost one here a week ago that they're not a good football team? So if the Russians lose one, or if Tully Blanchard loses one, or even if the Andersons lose one, does that mean we're any less a champion? Ric Flair loses one, does that mean he's not a champion? Of course not. You got to look at the long haul. Out of 1,000 matches, if the Russians win 999, you talk about the one. Out of 1,000 matches, if Flair wins 999, you talk about the one. That's what Dusty does. He talks about the one. That's what Magnum does. He talks about the one. And this kid in the ring right there is going to be talking about 2 seconds. But already he got tired. He got choked up. Arn is cool, calm, and gives him a knee right where he needs it. Right in the face, right in the chest. Good wrestling move. A sit out and a kick in the guts will do it every time.
Arn took a patented Anderson maneuver there. He took four or five shots, but he got that good one in. The one that counted and kept the tide of battle on his side.
Well, Uli just made that point a few moments ago that the Andersons are willing to take a shot. Two or three or four, they get one good blow of their own in. I think they have just that much confidence in their own ability to be able to deliver that one punch that's a telling blow.
Not only the confidence in their ability to deliver that one blow, but the ability to withstand several blows. I can remember looking at people who were really great at wrestling and just couldn't stand the pain and the punishment. We can take the pain. We can stand it. Arn right now is taking it. But you watch, see how that kid labors up or stands up when Arn starts coming back at him.
There was that opening, and Arn did not miss it. He did take advantage of it. This could be curtains.
I want two rounds.
Shoulders to the mat. You can hear from Arn Anderson, and you see it. I want you, Rhodes, as he's hollering at Dusty Rhodes. Johnny wants this in right here in slow motion.
Just a fantastic maneuver. It puts away another opponent for Arn Anderson. One half of the National Tag Team Champions. The word of the match, Arn Anderson.
We'll be right back.
Well, fans, you just saw Arn Anderson in action in the ring, and I tell you, whether it's as a tag team or a single, when you get the Andersons in there, you know you got action. And not only that, but if you're the opponent, you know you're going to have to fight tooth and nail to come out of there, not only with a win, but to even come out with your life. As Ole Anderson will tell you time and time again, the Andersons have the ability to be able to take a tremendous amount of punishment to get in the telling blow or two that they want to land on their opponent, which they know is going to put him away. The Andersons have lived by that rule for a long, long time. Ole Anderson, Gene Anderson, and now Arn Anderson, the Anderson brothers, the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, who have more or less written the book on tag team wrestling. And the reason is just because they're that tough. Here's Arn Anderson. Arn.
I sent you a candy gram, Daddy. A legend in your own time, American Dream, two times World Heavyweight Champion. Arn Anderson just sent you a candy gram in the form of Hard Rock Reeves. No difference in busting your head open than anybody else on the face of the earth. I deserve the World Television Championship, and I'm gonna have it. I don't care how many limbs I have to break. Tell them about it, Rock.
It's easy for Rhodes to stand here and tell everybody that he's the uncrowned World Heavyweight Champion. He deserves to have that national or world television title belt. But the only way I see that you could get anything at all, Rhodes, is by sneaking in behind, dropping a chair on the kid here, and then walking away. As soon as Arn turned around, where was Dusty Rhodes? Now, if it would have been me or it would have been Arn, we'd have walked up face to face and said, I'm taking that belt. That's what a man would have done. But not Dusty Rhodes. There's a whole bunch of them like that. They all have to sneak around. I tell you, we're here. We're not hard to find. Rhodes, Magnum TA, like I said, those Rock and Roll Express, I hear that music. I want to just about go and rip up a couple of radios and rip up a few people that are playing the darn things. I tell you, we're wrestlers. We're not fancy. We never claim to be fancy. We don't have all those robes. We don't carry all the jewelry. We don't have all the fancy cars. But we got the one thing that everybody wishes that they had. We've got the ability to wrestle, which makes us the best. And that's why we're the champions. And we're going to get that TV title, too.
Fans, the big Russians right here, and I'm sure you notice they're missing something, and that's the world tag team belts from around the waist. Ivan?
Oh, you think that's very funny. I heard the comment of the Rock and Roll Express that we're hot on their trails. That is an understatement. We're going to be breathing down your neck. Every time you get in the ring, you think about that. Watch the contracts you sign. Watch the stipulations. Because we're not going to stop until we get our World Tag Team belt back. Whether it's a week, a month, a year, the dedication and determination of the Kolar family is going to show you why we are supreme by taking those belts back. talking about battles and teams. These Road Warriors, they declared Third World War on us, and they seen us another occasion where we let them reign, showing that we're supreme, but then challenging us. And here again, you will see in a minute where these Road Warriors come out and unprovokedly attack us from behind. Whether it's political or personal reasons, or they didn't like what we're doing to their American friends, they come out and they take us. Now right here in America, in some states it is still allowed, where a man is punished for a crime, if it's bad enough, by hanging by the neck. But we are going to be the judge, and we're going to be the jury, and we're going to be the executioner on these roadways. We are going to be hanging them. This is only a sample of what we can do to them and what we are going to do to them. You remember, first of all, they declared Third World War on us, not their, us on them. We were saying we are supreme to them and we're going out to show that we are stronger, more powerful. But they took it on themselves to attack us. When you see here Nikita hanging him, yes, this is the sentence being carried out Russian style. Now, they'd better take warning from this. And as far as the world TV title, the Kremlin hasn't decided yet which one of us or all three of us is going up to win the tournament for this. But you can be sure of one thing. The Koloff family, if they do enter it, will be doing everything that we have to capture that world TV title.
The Russians, Ivan Koloff, Nikita Koloff, and Big Nikita is in the ring now, fans. So let's go to the ring. The Black Cat, the opponent, and there he is, Johnny, mask it off.
He may be in for a rough evening here because across the ring is his opponent, big, strong Nikita Koloff.
This man right here, Nikita Koloff, Johnny, has got to be one of the most powerful men in the world. He is so big and is so strong, he's got muscles to spare, and you just can't move a man around like that. Look here, the cat was going to try to slam him, and he can't even get him off his feet. Boy, when you talk about intense individuals, the Russians are just as intense as anybody. They go about it as if they have a plan in mind and they don't deviate one inch.
Indicated one or two losses does not deviate from the success of that team.
It's been on Nikita Koloff since the opening bell.
Really a feather in the hat of the Rock and Roll Express, the great team that they are, to defeat the Russians two times.
Johnny, that just proves the class of the Rock and Roll Express.
Brother, that was a close one.
The Russian Hammer. And when he rolls him over, that's all she wrote for the Black Cat.
The winner of the match, there he is, Nikita Koloff.
Here, the Raging Bull.
You know, some
Bob Cottle, you know, Thanksgiving night was a heck of a night. A lot of things to remember, a lot of people went down. You know, a lot of people swallowed a lot of turkey feathers. You know, I'm talking about my main man, Dustin Rhodes, was crowned world champion that night. Little stipulation might happen, but I still think the people of America today, the textile workers, all the people that were down, know that the real world champion, deep down in their heart and soul, is Dusty Rhodes, the American dream. Then my man, the Magnum, it seemed like he pulled the trigger. A man be crying about, he didn't say, I quit. Well, Daddy, whatever it says and may be, think back in the back of your mind every night when you wake up asleep in the shadows, baby. Think about who's wearing that belt and who's not. And then think about the bull, baby, the champion, the MDM, Mexican Death. Then you think about Jimmy Crockett got a tournament coming for the world TV title that Arnie Anderson and so-called Ole Anderson think that they own outright. Well, Daddy, I don't toss my name around anywhere unless I plan to be there. And I made it a point to come to Jimmy Crockett and say the bull wants a piece of this action. And when the bull wants a piece of action, Daddy, he goes to town and gets it. So, Ole Anderson, you can come out here and you can talk about anybody and you can say all you want about wrestling, Daddy, but it comes from the heart and the soul and a drive from a person inside and pride to get the job done. And Dusty Rhodes, the American dream, my main man always will be. You understand, he can team up with the Raging Bull on any given night. And you're going to see the awesome team that you've seen before, one-time World Tag Team Champion, come back and demolish some people. Yes, Ole Anderson, I'm talking to you, baby. I know the word didn't come out of your mouth because you were quivering in fear of the Raging Bull alone. And so is Arn Anderson. And I'll duel the Butcher and the Barbarian, anybody else. But I guarantee you one thing, Bob Cottle. When the night's through, the Rock and Roll Express is holding on to something that America always wanted. The World Tag Team title. And the Russians be crying to the Gremlin, or the Kremlin, whatever you want to call it. But America, like the textile workers, Daddy, never goes down, never. Every time you shoot us down, we get right back up and get in your face. Because in today, it's called Guts and Glory, and the bull is full of it. So come get me if you can.
All right, fans, and that's going to wrap it up for this week. We'll see you next week. And until then, so long for now.
Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling is a presentation of the JCP Sports Network and has been furnished to the station for broadcast at this time in exchange for commercial consideration.